Hey, what's up everyone? Been a long time, but I thought I'd come back and just do a little bit of talking about the two most expensive microphones that you can possibly have. You're born with them, and they're your ears. Just a little bit of health and I guess well-being for all of us. That's something that we need to take care of, and that's our ears. When we make music, I think a lot of the times it's something that we tend to neglect is how we treat our hearing. I know that for sometimes I'm listening to music at loud levels for sometimes, you know, hours at a time and not stop to think about the damage that we might or I might be doing to my hearing. One of the things that could seriously damage your hearing from prolonged listening to loud music is tinnitus. Now, tinnitus is a symptom of hearing loss or hearing damage. Essentially, the way we hear is that we have tiny little hairs in our ear that, you know, that vibe, that pick up sound waves and translate down our ear canal and basically tell us what we're hearing, which is sound. Now, when those hairs become damaged, they begin to spaz out for other words. And that ends up being either a ringing or a buzzing or sometimes sort of a whistling sound in the ears. Now, that can be very quiet or that can be very loud. In our ears, our ears are responsible for a lot of our balance. So a lot of people that have extensive hearing loss or hearing damage will have either a loss of balance or a feeling of vertigo, like they'll never be able to be fully, I don't know, they won't feel balanced. So what can we do? Basically, be aware of how long and how loud we're listening to our music. One of the things that we should be aware of is also for all of us that use synthesizers and samplers, these are unnatural sounds that we're listening to, meaning that the sounds that our synthesizers and samplers produce aren't naturally occurring in this world. They're not like the sound of trees or wind or anything natural. They're synthetic sounds that are synthesized, and I don't know if there's been any research into how much of these sounds differ from natural sounds and what the effect is on our hearing. Their frequency range extends longer or wider than what we are normally used to, and the effects of that we just don't know yet. So something to be aware of. Also, just on a side note, today I was speaking at work today with a lady, and we're talking about the Chilean miners that were that are now being brought up to the surface in Chile. And there were scientists, when they first got trapped down there, they wanted to figure out the most important things that somebody needed to survive. Now, number one on the list, ironically, was music. So that just goes to show that, you know, what we do is very important, and we won't be able to do it very long if we don't take care of our ears, especially as we get older. I know, you know, hearing loss is pretty much inevitable for a lot of us, but while we're young, we want to protect our ears, and that's about it. Hope you guys had fun listening, and, you know, take care. Peace.